about in-game, so guys that are playing in the game but sitting for longer stretches. You know, like, for example, D'Angelo recently, who's been having times where he's sitting kind of for longer stretches, getting back in, trying to get his rhythm back.
What about it?
How do you see it affect him?
You know, sometimes they come in and they're ready to, they're sharp and they get it done right away. There's other times where it feels like they need a couple minutes to kind of get going. You know, but you know, they're young enough that their bodies should be ready to react. You know, in my opinion, to, you know, coming right in the game. And I think the most important thing is when you're on the bench, to not just be there supporting, but to actually be watching what's happening. You know, the game's always changing, and as it changes, so is the way we're playing it. Whether somebody gets hot and, you know, we're gonna switch, you know, we're gonna change our defensive scheme to a 1-4 switch everything. Whatever it is, you have to be alert and paying attention so that when you get back in the game, you know, there's no drop off to the intensity level. But I think that they'll get better at it the more experience they have with it, and it's probably not going to change because our bench has been so good for us all year. We're not going to shorten the bench's minutes to get them, you know, off the bench. I mean, the starters back in sooner because the bench most nights is putting up big numbers for us.
You had just mentioned the attentiveness and how important it is on the bench. As a head coach, do you notice those types of things, like how guys react when they're on the bench, or do you rely on your assistant coaching staff to notice that?
A lot of times I'll rely on the assistant coaches. Sometimes I'll look down, and if I see our bench just sitting there and not, you know, not into it, I'll get up and say something to them. But you know, most times I leave that up to the assistants to kind of navigate through the games.
Have you ever had to do that this season, or have they been pretty good about just
being? They've been pretty good. I've done it a couple times, though, where, you know, it's good. It's not only good for, you know, for them on the bench, but it helps the guy on the court. Like, when the whole bench is calling out defensive coverages when our defense is in front of us, it helps us. It lets us know what's coming. So I think it's just a good habit to get into.
Has there been one guy that you've always been able to rely on that's always on the bench alert?
T-Rob's normally the most consistent with it. He's up on his feet cheering. Larry's, before Larry got hurt, Larry was pretty good with it. But those two are it. But most of the guys have been pretty solid about it all year.
How has T-Rob handled his changing role in the last?
He's a strong guy.
That's what I keep telling him. So as soon as you get down in the stance, you're going to be a monster on the defense end. T-Rob?
Yes, how has he handled, because he hasn't been playing lately after being a
T-Rob's been good. He is. I mean, I can sense frustration, but I should. Nobody should be happy about not playing, but that only turns into an issue if you come into practice and pout and soak and whatnot. And he's been here working his tail off just like he was the first time he wasn't playing, and just like he was when he was playing. So he's still giving us the same effort, even though he's, you know, he's probably a little frustrated he's not playing. Well, we were struggling too, and then yeah, Zoo came in. He's been playing great with every opportunity he's had. So you know, it's, I said before, it wouldn't have been fair for me not to play T-Rob when he got his opportunities and was playing that well, and now it was Zoo playing that well during you know, small stretches. You know, it's only fair to give Zoo those opportunities.